Welcome to this session about why do we need systematic reviews of prognosis studies. The reasons for this are more or less in line like the reasons why we need systematic reviews for therapeutic interventions or diagnostic test accuracy studies. So it's very helpful if there is an information overload. So there are a lot of publications available, and you want to have an overview of them. And it's twofold. So you want to have an overview of them because you want to know what the information load is. So what do we know already? What is already researched? And systematic reviewers are also developed in to assess how the studies were performed. So you get an overview of what is out there, and also you get an overview of the quality of the information. So we see, for example, that the number of studied prognostic factors is increases rapidly per day, and especially the information on all the biomarkers is growing very fast. But also, there are many studies published on prognostic models. For example, at the Julius Center in Utrecht in the Netherlands, we worked on a systematic review looking at all the models that were developed on predicting future cardiovascular diseases risks. And there were almost 400 models developed and validated. So that's a huge number of studies, and you can see while going through the list that it's rather the rule than the exception that there are many, many different models developed for the same outcome, so for the same target condition or for the same health state we want to predict. So you can ask the question whether or not that's essential to do, or whether we could avoid some sort of these type of studies and better focus on how to implement these type of information. So as said before, it's systematic reviews are written to give an overview of all the information overload, but also to assess the quality. So what is the certainty of the included evidence? And for prognosis studies, we see that there's a lot of heterogeneity among these type of studies, and there's even more variability in prognosis studies than that there is in intervention studies, mostly randomized controlled trials, so very strict pre-designed study design, or in the diagnostic test accuracy studies. So the variation is mainly amongst the population, so there's a variation in case mix, but also huge variation in study design. So it's often not pre-designed. We use existing data sets, and in these existing data sets, all the variables were already measured and all the outcomes were already measured. And often this is not across the studies standardized, and sometimes even not within the study. So a lot of variation there. So how do we need these type of how do we use these type of systematic reviews? Because we have an overview now of all the information, and we have also an overview of the certainty of the evidence, and this is information we can use in our clinical decision making. So these type of systematic reviews provide trusted evidence for a huge variation of different stakeholders to help them deciding which factor or which model to use in clinical practice or to implement in evidence-based guidelines, for example. And because we give an overview of all the information, it's also a very helpful tool to identify gaps in the knowledge. So we can identify and indicate areas where future studies are needed, but also very essential, as we saw, for example, in the information overload for all the prognostic models that were developed, we identify areas where there may be already enough studies done or performed. So we can also use them to avoid future unnecessary studies, because most of the information is already out there, although some people were not aware of it and we don't use it yet in clinical practice. And also as a methodologist, we use the overviews of the primary studies always to highlight the flaws in the conduct of the primary studies, in the reporting of the primary studies, and thereby trying to improve the information in the primary studies.